Hello, this is another podcast extra from CelticUnderground.net. This week with the audio from the post-match interviews of the Celtic Hibs game.
People might say that I should strive for more, but I'm so happy I can see the bright things happening here.
So we got the post-game interviews from Brendan Rodgers, Neil Lennon, who loses it with the press, a Hibs player whose name escapes me for the moment, and French Eddie with some translation. This forward passing lark could really catch on with these 10 goals in two games, and the first goal sums up the benefit of forward passing. Lustig's in trouble on the right with the Hibs player closing him down. Last month and for the previous 12, he'd have passed it back to a centre-half. Today, he passed it forward and the goal came. So, this is me, Harry Brady, passing over to Brendan, Lenny, a Hibs player, and French Eddie, and his translator. So what you get, you've made your bed, you better lie in it. You choose your leaders and place your trust. As their lives will shut down and their promises rust. You'll see killing machines with proper rockets and guns.
Well, probably why you're all here. And it was always going to be a fantastic football game with two teams that actually started the game to want to win the game. And I thought we were outstanding today. Our combination play, and it was a game. As a coach and a manager, you have to work very hard in as well. You know, we started the game in 4-3-3, and they were playing 3-5-2. We went 2-0 up. They changed the game to a diamond. We then changed to go to 3-diamond-3 at half time. So there was lots of work in the game as a coach, and I love that aspect of playing. So yeah, it was a really, really good game of football. Lots of great play from ourselves. We'll analyse the couple of goals we gave away, but I take my hat off to the two Hibs boys because I thought they finished them really, really well. But overall, we scored 4 goals. I hit the woodwork 4 times. Had other opportunities where we had a bit more finesse. We could have finished the game, but a wonderful attacking performance from ourselves, and actually put a lot of work into our pressing, which is very important against a good Hibs team.
Double Frost and Ed one as well, but I suppose there were so many impressive performances.
Yeah, I thought the rhythm and that speed in our game was back. We've seen it coming over the past numbers of weeks, and obviously highlight it against St Johnson, but really pleasing to have that fluency and combination play with the guys being away on international duty. So, but to come back and play to that level against a very, very good team, it was very pleasing.
Scott Brown taking off in the first half. You had an update of how
was he? We won't know until the next couple of days. He looked like he was struggling, and you know what he's like. He wants to play and play on, but he wasn't going to do himself or the team any favours. He was just struggling to get about the pitch. So, but we'll see how he is in a couple of days' time.
Is that the same thing you had before?
I don't know. He thought it was maybe his calf. He thinks it's maybe his knee. So we just have to wait and see.
On a domestic level, I mean, is that as close to being back to your best? You know, it's taken well this season to get going. But that was free-flowing and clinical.
Yeah, I think we've all seen the sort of development of the team. I think in the summer, I mentioned before, you know, we stood still. As a club, we should have really went into another gear. We didn't do that, and obviously now we're starting to move again, you know, and we're starting to play with that quality and that level that I know we can play at. So, but it's the work the players are putting in. You know, we've never been frustrated with them. It's always important to work and continue to believe in you and never doubt how you work and how you play. And I think, like you say, slowly we're getting to that level. But give Hibs some credit today as well, because they're a very good side, good pace in the team, and Neil's done a fantastic job there with him. So it was a game we're always going to have to be concentrated, because they've got the ability to score goals. But I thought our real quality shone through today, and we were at a really high level going forward.
Do you admire them for coming out and having a go, as opposed to just sit back, try to get counter? They believe in themselves to go for it.
Yeah, listen, there's no right or wrong style, you know. Teams will come here and sit in, and you can't argue with that. That's what that's what you've got to do. That's, you know, they do to get results. They both need an eye. Our ideas are very much attacking philosophy, you know. So go and impose yourself onto a game, you know, and I think if you can do that, you've got greater chances to win games. So that's how the game was. So it was probably, I think what was really good from my perspective, what I'm happy with, is that we were winning the game, but we probably entertained the people today. I think there probably hasn't been enough times this season where we've done that. We've had some great results, some good performances, but in the first couple of years we were really winning, but winning well and winning with real style, and I think we've done that today, and it's great for the supporters who pay their money to come and watch the team, and this is what Celtic's synonymous for.
Forrest is in particularly good form, but you're also particularly happy Edwards now finding the net consistently as well.
Yeah, he's a top class player, there's I've never had any doubt about that. He's played out of position at times, you know, he's played off the left side whenever Lee's played central, because it doesn't work with the two of them right up there, so he's had to forfeit a little bit for the team. But you know, if you look at his stats when he plays, or plays as a striker, he's a goal scorer. He's different to both Lee and Musselwhere, but he's a top talent. You know, could have had 3-4 goals today, you know, but the fluency when he plays up there, and how he moves and how he presses, and our intelligent players work off that.
Callum dropped deep again after Scott went off. How do you feel he did in that role?
I thought he was brilliant. Yeah, he's a player that, there's only one problem. When you move Callum McGregor, you want Callum McGregor to be in the other position, you know, and then when you move him, you want him to be in another position. He's absolutely tactically brilliant. You know, he played, you think what he played, played three positions today. Played wide in a 4-3-3, coming inside. Played as then the holding player in the 4-3-3. Holding player in the bottom of a diamond, and then the left side of a diamond. He's just tactically brilliant. His view of the game is so good. His brain is of a really, really top level performer. You know, tactically, he's such a special player to work with. And he's got this really unique quality for up here in Scotland as he keeps the ball, which at the top level you have to be able to do. And like I say, he's such a top class player, and keeps the speed of the game going for us. So I thought he was very, very good.
Is Scott going to be a question mark for Thursday night, Brendan, or would you expect?
I would think so, Gordon. We'll just see how it looked, the sore one when he was coming off. I just have to wait and see on that. But you know what he's like, he's a warrior, and he'll do everything he can to be there. But we'll just have to wait and see.
You expect to have Griffiths back? Sorry.
Not sure, Derek. He got injured early on in the week, then back to get fit, and then he's been ill the last 3 days. So we're hoping the combination of both can be cleared up for some point next week. But we just have to wait and see.
Yeah, I was frustrated with him the first half. He didn't do the things that we wanted to do. And he got exposed a little bit pace-wise in certain areas, which is alright. I thought in the final third of times we were lacking belief in the first half. We had good chances and good areas, and we let Celtic off a hook at times. But the change of shape, I gambled with the formation, which I always want to do. Because there's no point in coming here with one striker and letting Celtic play all day and win 1-0. You don't learn anything from that. So we exposed them in the second half. We were a lot better second half. The strikers decided to turn up for the second half, and we had a real good go at it. And 3-2, you're thinking, well, we have them. We've got them exposed a little bit. But we just lacked a little bit of pace in certain areas, and that was the difference between the teams today. Although, to be fair to Celtic, they were very good going forward in the first half, and we could have been a few more up.
So that was probably the frustration
thing.
It goes 2-1, you're back in it, and then it goes 3-2, you're back in it again. You just couldn't really get that footing to ensure that it was kept going.
Well, a 2-1, you're thinking, good, you know. Milligan has to take Forrest out. do the dark arts better, take a yellow card for the team. You should know at 33. You know, you can't let them run away from you in those areas. So then we get back to 3-2. And we should do better with the fourth goal. But you can analyse. The second goal for me is really annoying because we have possession of the ball and we decide to pass square balls across our back three and then drop Louis Stevenson in the cart who gives it away in midfield and they break and score. So a 2-0 down, you're on the defensive, really. You know, you've got to think about how you're going to get back into it. And we did. Gordon makes an unbelievable save from the header. And then we have a break at 2-1 with Boyle. Of all people, you want to just go on, run away, and then slide in Horgan. And we didn't make the most of that. So they got a bit of a rocket at half-time, and then they came out and played really well second half.
And the two finishes, as you mentioned, compared to Boyle's first
draw as well. Yeah, and then Slivka has a shot, could have went anywhere, gets deflected wide, and we had a few other sort of chances. But we lacked a little bit of belief in the first half, which annoyed me a little bit. But I'll take responsibility for the first half, because they set the team out to play that way, and go 1v1 at times all over the pitch. Because I think that's the right thing to do.
You think you still showed enough, Neil, to underline that he's in a top of the table threat?
No, not really. Second half, maybe. I'm sick of hearing this title contention sort of stuff. They've got a budget of £16 million. They've got a £9 million striker. I've got free transfers and rejects from other clubs who are playing brilliantly for me. I'm really pleased with what I saw second half. But over, you know, a 38-game season, it's very, very difficult to maintain that consistency, especially against the quality that we face today. And when you are playing against 12 men as well, it's very difficult, because I thought the referee was abysmal. How Bankovic doesn't get a yellow card and McGregor does is beyond me. He's taken Heyman completely out of the game. We get a free kick on the edge of the box, no yellow card. Someone, he says he's not going near the goal, it doesn't matter. The intent is just to take the player out. And then we get flagged for offside from a tackle, a defensive tackle, when we're breaking. Anyway, I digress.
The inconsistency, because he gave two very early yellow cards,
yeah,
and didn't seem to then follow that up at all.
Well, the Bankovic one for me is borderline red, never mind a yellow, and he gets nothing. He just took Heyman completely out. He knew what he was doing, there's no intent to play the ball. So it baffles me why that's not a yellow card. I'm not here to get players sent off, I'm just looking for the referee to do his job properly.
Was that the route? There seemed to be a wee bit of rancour between the dugouts towards the end of the come.
What did Brendan say about that? Did you ask him? No. Why are you asking me then?
Because you seem to be involved in it. I didn't see Brendan.
Well, why didn't you ask Brendan about it?
But Brendan didn't seem to be involved in
it. I wasn't involved in anything.
Was it Gary and Chris Davis?
Look, we'll keep it ourselves. We'll sit for another time.
Was it, in general, was it a comment made?
You're asking me a question that you didn't ask the Celtic manager. Their bench was involved, my bench was involved, yet you didn't ask him the question, did you? Did you? Why not? But you're asking me, so you're looking for a byline or a headline or something, you're not getting one. That'll keep. Any more questions?
Thank you. Manager was saying that he was very unhappy at half-time, would that be an understatement? How would you describe
his? Yep, we've had worse though, but no, he was definitely not happy. I mean, I think we let ourselves down as well. We let him down. You know, the way we started wasn't acceptable. And, you know, the first goal was a great strike, but the second one, you know, it could have been much preventable. And yeah, you can't give them two goals like that, unfortunately.
He sent you out there in a very adventurous fashion, to be fair, and he acknowledged that himself. He said, there's no point in coming here. We're not going to go and do that. As a group of players, do you feel that that's the right approach to it?
Yeah, I mean, we don't like to sit back. You know, we just come out, we know we try to play a normal game, get on the ball and try to create as much chances as we can. I feel like we did create a lot of chances, but they were much more clinical today than us. And I'd say we gifted them a few goals, and yeah, that's why they're champions, I'm afraid.
The quality of the two finishes, though, I mean, I appreciate now they're not going to count much for you in defeat, but two superb goals.
Yeah, I know, we're just chasing the game now. We know we thought we could have got something from the game, but as you say, they're very good on the break, and you know, they've got clinical players like that that can catch us out, and you know, that's what they did.
The Gordon save from you, what, about a minute before the
break? Yeah, I thought it was in. I was somebody celebrating, but as you say, he's a top goalie, and you know, he's number one here for a reason, and we're making saves like that, so credit to him, so yeah.
Thank you. What difference would that have made?
Yeah, I mean, it would have made a huge difference. But like you say, it's not what people say. You just take it on the chin and you try to create more. But, you know, he keeps his team in the game. And, you know, they go out and score another goal. And, you know, our heads drop before half time. But as you say, we come out to try rectify it the second half and got on the ball. And, you know, we were causing them more problems than we did.
Thank you,
Mark.
Cheers.
Watson, just how pleased were you with your performance and your two goals this afternoon?
Très content avec le jeu aujourd'hui et la performance de l'équipe.
Ouais, c'était important pour nous de gagner ce match. Voilà, c'est par les matchs comme ça que. On avance en équipe
ouais.
Et c'est aujourd'hui c'est important pour nous car ça va nous aider à avancer pour la suite du championnat.
So it's really important to win today. It's important to demonstrate to everyone that we're still a team and that we are aiming for that top spot. We're still number one.
Is John Feely back to his best spot?
Tu penses que tu as la forme parfaite maintenant? Tu as la forme meilleure que avant?
Après mon retour de blessure, c'était un peu compliqué.
After his injury, it was a bit more complicated.
Maintenant, ça va de mieux en mieux, ça se voit sur le terrain.
Everything's
maintenant, il faut que
well,
je continue à monter en puissance.
Yeah, he feels a lot. He feels really, really fit.
If anything, you could score four, maybe today.
Tu penses que tu vas marquer plus de deux aujourd'hui?
Normalement aujourd'hui j'en aurais dû mettre 4 avec mes deux poteaux.
Normally it's not just 4 he's going for every single one.
The goalkeeper played well, that denied you.
Ouais, l'autre équipe va jouer très bien aujourd'hui et tu penses que c'est ça?
Ouais, c'était une bonne équipe en face. Voilà, on le savait maintenant, ils ont fait un beau début de championnat.
So really good team that they were played and they knew that going into the game. So they knew they had to play the strongest game against them and they showed that with the two goals that they scored. They scored back.
How does he feel about the Leipzig game now?
Qu'est-ce que tu penses du match contre Leipzig le jeudi?
C'est un match très important pour nous.
Very important.
Maintenant, on va le préparer au mieux.
Yeah, you need to prepare better for it.
Pour essayer de faire la meilleure performance possible.
They have to prepare the best possible way for this match to do better than the previous one.
There might not be Lee Griffiths, there might not be Scott Brown.
Mm-hmm.
Can Celtic still get a result in Germany?
Qu'est-ce que tu penses d'une équipe sans Scott Brown, sans Griffiths? Tu penses que c'est bien pour l'équipe?
C'est des joueurs importants dans l'équipe, donc ça nous pénalise un peu. Maintenant, on a un bon effectif, il y a beaucoup de joueurs. Maintenant, on va faire en sorte que les joueurs qui prennent leur place se mettent au niveau de l'équipe.
They are two really, really important players for the team, and they know that they will be a big loss. But they have lots of players who are ready to step in and perform for the team and get the win.
Bring me sunshine in your smile.
So that was all the post-game interviews. As you can hear, Lenny not happy with the tone, extent, range of questioning that came in for him there. I have a bit of sympathy. He was asked, but Brendan Rodgers wasn't. The counter to that would be, I just looked across and saw, after we'd scored the goal, as the celebrations were going up, I just looked across and saw somebody from the Hibs dugout pulling somebody else from the Hibs dugout in, and was oblivious to anything connected with the Celtic dugout on that. So if a journalist had seen as much as I'd seen, then you would only ask Neil Lennon the question, because you'd be oblivious that Celtic were involved. Anyway, enough of that. It was a great performance. Forward passing is the future. Win the next couple of games and everything will be looking really good with Leipzig coming up midweek, Hearts in the Cup and then Hearts in the League. So enough of me. That was me, Harry Brady, with the guys. And yes, I always say this every week, there'll be more podcasts along soon, but actually there genuinely will be, because I'm recording one on Wednesday night. So it's me, Harry Brady, saying goodnight and God bless. Good night. As the sun from up above, bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring